Dear students, today we will be talking about multimedia approach in educational technology. First, I'll give a brief introduction of the topic. A set of pertinent questions exist in almost every teacher, that is, how to make teaching learning process interesting, effective and long-lasting, and how to produce learning that is meaningful and productive. The answer to these questions lies in the appropriate selection and application of the important components such as teaching methods, strategies and techniques, along with the usage of different teaching learning materials which work as media to communicate the information from senders to the receivers in. They are teachers and students respectively. In other words, it is answered through educational technology, which involves the application of systematic organization of knowledge into solution of educational problems. It helps in reaching the goals of education in one of the most appropriate and proper manners. Here, education refers to something that equips the learners with essential skills, knowledge, capabilities, and attitude, which is helpful and prerequisite for their future roles. With changing time and scenario, there are visible changes in education and its processes. The traditional concept of teaching and instruction is more teacher-centered and inadequate in today's context. So, modern approach, including technological tools, helps in making learning deliberate, purposeful, meaningful, and organized. There are different methods, materials and appliances which are being used for producing learning. With advancement in almost all fields of life, educational materials, methods and strategies need transformation. Multimedia is one of the approaches which empower the educational processes through interaction between teachers and learners. It can be used in the field of educational technology to bring desirable outcomes as per the changing needs and demands of society. It helps in providing rich learning experiences to learners and more effective and efficient learning environment. Here, considering its importance in the field of education, it is prerequisite to be acquainted with the multimedia approach and its benefits in the field of education. Now we will see the meaning and concept of multimedia. Media are meant for broadcasting and publishing information. These media are defined as transmitters of information, which are considered as carriers of messages from some transmitting source, which may be human being or an inanimate object, to the receiver of the message, which is the learner. Newspaper with text, graphics and images were first mass communication medium, followed by motion pictures, wireless radio, television, computers and other advanced technological tools which changed and keep on changing the world of communication. All teaching is mediated through different media, be it the traditional media or the modern communication technologies. A lecturer mediates information through gestures, voice and board work, or in other words through chalk and talk. A student while reading a book receives writer's knowledge through the medium of printed pages. It can be said that all teaching and learning is mediated instruction. There are different forms of media such as narrative, interactive, communicative, adaptive, and productive, which produce the learning experiences such as attending and apprehending, investigating and exploring, discussing and debating, experimenting and practicing, articulating and expressing, media includes the means to create, store, and present instructional content, including tools such as chalk and talk, books and computers, slide projectors, video projection, document cameras, audio and video systems, etc. Each medium has its own unique characteristics and essential pedagogical implications, which are selected according to the learner's need and instructional objectives. These media can help to bridge the gap between learning needs and teaching resources. It is evident that media are best used in combination with variety of other instructional materials and techniques. These media are categorized as still pictures, audio, motion pictures, television, real things and people, models and simulation, and programmed and computer-assisted instructions. In multimedia approach, different media, new or old, are integrated together for better teaching and learning. It is defined as the presentation of instruction that involves more than one delivery media, presentation mode and or sensory modalities. In other words, it is the multiple forms of media presentation. The integration of these media makes learning experiences more interactive, creative, dynamic, and motivating. The term multimedia was introduced in 1960s to describe the combined use of several media such as text, film, still images, audio, and video. According to Phillips, multimedia is characterized by the presence of text, pictures, sound, animation, and video, same or all of which are organized into some coherent program. In Oxford Dictionary of Education, it is defined as the use of a range of teaching resources, particularly information, communication, technology, to reinforce or support learning. In the words of Schnodds and Lowe, multimedia is defined as the combination of multiple technical resources for the purpose of presenting information represented in multiple formats via multiple sensory modalities. According to Malik and Agarwal, multimedia is a melody sung in harmony with multi-channel and multimodal bits of knowledge and creation. Multimedia tool is an instrument of perception, comprehension, application, deduction, and systematization of new learning materials. The components of multimedia approach to effective teaching are interactive methods and techniques, multimedia tools, and multimedia products. Now we will see the features of multimedia. On the basis of earlier quoted definitions of multimedia and its related discussions, various features of multimedia are elaborated briefly in the following ways. Multimedia involves use of a number of media devices and techniques for teaching and learning. It may involve text, graphics, pictures, video, audio, sound, and animation. It gives variety of learning experiences by fostering team building and provides hands-on practices. It offers a better pattern for exploring new teaching learning models. It is used and organized in coherent manner as per the predetermined objectives of teaching. Its main purpose is to support and reinforce learning. Different media and its integration in properly structured manner facilitate acquisition and learning of new concepts and ideas more effectively and efficiently. multimedia approach makes teaching learning go beyond the verbal version of the subject that is given through lectures only. By providing direct representation of reality, chances for self-assessment and other modes of experiences. It brings changes in traditional ways of teaching and learning, where teachers remain the sole authority in the classroom and students are passive recipients of knowledge. Now, let's see the advantages of multimedia. Regarding advantages of multimedia, Malik and Agarwal have stated, multimedia facilitates mastering basic skills of a student by means of drills and practices. It helps in problem solving by means of learning by doing, understanding abstract concepts, provides enhanced access for teachers and students in remote locations, facilitates individualized and cooperative learning, helps in management and administration of classroom activities and learning content, and stimulates real-life problem handling environments. Considering these words, different advantages of multimedia approach are given in the following points. Multimedia is changing the ways of learning. For example, learning languages through text materials is less effective and relevant than the use of language laboratory, where multiple media are used for involving more senses and giving opportunities for drills and practices in more realistic context. It helps in creation of interactive learning environment that can support and assist teachers and students in teaching learning process. Through the usage of multimedia, multiple resources are available to learners for exploration of novel ideas. It provides flexibility in learning concepts. It is not unimodal, where one activity or style is considered as the only existing one, but it provides the range of useful activities and teaching learning styles for more fruitful results. It promotes flexibility in teaching as well as learning processes and tries to make learning more individualized or personalized. It promotes cooperative learning, critical thinking, and problem-solving abilities among learners. It helps in encouraging and enhancing peer learning without harming or diminishing individual creativity and innovation. It gives opportunities for self-regulated and autonomous activities. It increases students' engagement, motivation, social skills, and digital and multimedia skills. Now, let's see disadvantages of multimedia. Along with its various features and advantages, multimedia has some disadvantages, such as it requires highly sophisticated infrastructural facilities which lead to financial burden. So, lack of infrastructure is the disadvantage of multimedia approach, and the appropriate selection, usage and handling of multimedia is important in this approach to educational technology, which requires trained and well-skilled teachers. So, lack of trained teachers is one of the disadvantages of multimedia approach. If facilities are given, there is lack of trained teachers to use them effectively and efficiently. To conclude, it can be stated that multimedia approach refers to the usage of different media, including text, graphics, still and motion pictures, audio, video, and animations. It has universal application in the fields of education, science, and technology, and medicine, etc. It is very effective in gaining and holding attention of learners. It is more student-centric in nature and provides individualized learning experiences along with teamwork and collaboration. Its effectiveness depends upon the skill of selection and organization of media according to the needs of learners and instructional objectives. A teacher needs to be aware of different media and its applications so that he or she can plan, design, produce, and implement it in teaching learning processes. The integration of different media should activate more and more senses to create rich learning environment for producing meaningful and productive learning. That is the ultimate goal of instruction. Thank you.